Some crew members are causing a disturbance on the ship. Now arriving at Phineas's top secret orbital lab.
Hello? Can you hear me? Does this work? I'm just securing my ongoing experiments. And securing myself. Mind the mess. I haven't had a visitor since, In fact, I've never had a visitor.
You. I'd clap you on the shoulder if I weren't behind a wall of bulletproof glass. I don't know how you did it, but Hiram Blythe just sent me everything I needed. According to Hiram's message, Minister Clark has ordered a suspicious amount of dimethyl sulfoxide. It's almost as if he's hoarding the colony's remaining supply. Typical elitist, hoarding supplies during a time of scarcity. Once I have those chemicals, we can revive the Hope's colonists and put some decent people in charge. So, good news. You're going to Byzantium and stealing those chemicals. Exciting. Ah, yes, the details. I'm not about to ask you to rampage through Byzantium trading bullets with the board's agents. We'll have to resort to subterfuge. Carmen Imagawa. She's my contact in Byzantium. Meet her at the docks. She'll have all the necessary intelligence you require. I'm giving you my old nav key to Byzantium. You'll need it to land in the Golden City. Remember, you're looking for dimethyl sulfoxide. Big green bubbling vessel with a warning label. I'll take as much as you can find. Something about being discontinued due to severe adverse reactions. It's fine. You'll be stealing the chemicals, not ingesting them. You can trust her if that's what you're asking. Imagawa is the finest special agent in Byzantium that money can buy. My money, anyway.
Why was I built to feel ennui? We are now in orbit above Byzantium, Captain. We'll be here, Captain, or will we?
Do you mind? I'm meeting someone. You mean I'm supposed to be meeting you. Nothing, it's just... I thought you'd be taller. Anyway, let's not get hung up on that. The Phoenix is a wanted man, and the board has eyes everywhere in Byzantium. Yeah, that's my code name for, you know, our mutual friend. Oh, I'm Golden Eagle. Yeah, I named you Cuckoo. It makes sense if you think about it, because I didn't know who you were, and old Earth cuckoos would routinely trick other birds into feeding them.
Oh, can I be chicken? Because chickens will adopt any critter's baby and keep them warm.
You sure you don't want to be Raven or Sparrowhawk?
Aw.
Okay. Chicken it is.
This cloak and dagger stuff is nonsense, but if everyone else gets a code name, I want one too.
You can be Cassowary.
That's shockingly apt. Cassowaries were a solitary bunch. But once they had a friend, they'd stick with them till the end.
Aggressive little creatures, too. Anyway, you're looking to make contact with Minister... Magpie, right? I should warn you, it won't be easy. He spends most of his time in his estate, which is heavily guarded. Afraid not. He almost never leaves his home, and his guards never leave him.
Can't say I blame him. It's scary out of doors. I mean, can you even count how many times we've been shot at?
What work specialists, huh? Our mutual friend is really branching out. Whoa, I'm not one of your B&E specialists. I just provide intelligence. Some of the guards hang around Billingsley's House of Inebriation between shifts.
House of Inebriation? Count me the hell in!
Maybe you could do some reconnaissance there. You know, swipe a key while nobody's looking. Just remember, you didn't hear it from me. Good luck, Cuckoo.
Why can't something exciting happen around here for once?
Nothing wrong with stability. It means everything's running like clockwork.
Don't you ever want a little fun? Maybe see a marauder ship get blown to bits overhead?
Hey, you! Yeah, you! Wanna be famous?
Anti-Creon's level head.
Is that supposed to be a model of the system? Not super accurate.
Ugh. Decadence ain't gonna save you when beasts chew through the walls.
Hey! Stand back! You... I'm part of Minister Clark's personal detail, and that means you gotta keep 5 feet back at all times. Yep, you're looking at the Minister's newest personal guard, right here. The others took me out to celebrate on account of me just getting hired and all. He's basically the most important person in the colony, which makes me the most important guard in the colony. Yeah. That means I got a key to the minister's estate, my own personal UDL-issued shotgun. They don't give those out to just anyone. That's right. Not just anyone is allowed to have a key to Minister Clark's residence. It's all so very high level. That's a great idea! I'll have a Spectrum vodka.
Captain, I can smell him from clear over here. I reckon he's had a fair number already.
Sure have, because today's my big day.
He's got powerful good ears, too.
And a powerful thirst. You have a Spectrum vodka for a new pal? Here's to me. Hey, you're really great. Have I told you that? We should be friends. Wow, listen to me. I'm soaked. I should probably slow down before I'm face down on the tile somewhere. Who am I kidding? I could have another. You got another? It's not every day you get your dream job, right? Wow! You've got, like, this crazy energy. Has anyone ever told you that? You're like a manosaur. You got a manosaur energy. Oh, Laws, I gotta stop. I'm seeing at least two of you.
Only two? You got a ways to go.
Have you always been here? I didn't see you a minute ago. I really shouldn't. I'll have the worst hangover tomorrow if I don't stop. You sure sound like you know what you're talking about. Okay, here goes. Ugh. Was that one supposed to taste like purple berry crunch? Or am I just tasting breakfast? I don't feel so good. I think I'm gonna be sick. I just need help. Ah!
I've always loved that skull.
Is Lightfield still drinking?
It is probably.
Citizens, today marks a monumentous occasion in the course of Halcyon history.
Move along.
After a UDL security examination of our budgets, revenue streams, and predictive models, we are publishing our yearly success report. Profits are soaring, promotions abound. Thanks to your continued hard work, Halcyon is healthier and more productive than ever. In the coming months, Byzantium will be sure to see the many rewards reaped from your diligent labor. Once we nail down the details, I can't wait to share what's in store. For now, my friends, keep up the hard work.
Is it me, or could each of these homes fit all of Edgewater inside? Cannery and all.
This property is off limits.
solicitors, loiterers, and uninvited visitors will be fined to the fullest extent of company policy. This ultimatum brought to you by Universal Defense Logistics.
Huh?
Huh?
You! You're not one of my guards. What are you doing here?
Oh, my law. Captain! Captain! That's the minister! Mr. Clark! Oh, wow!
If this is about another Aetherwave clip or radio spot,
You may kindly fuck off, as the parlance goes. I'm not doing any more. Drugs, of course. What else would it be? I don't have any drugs. You should try a vending machine or a purveyor of curative goods.
He's got no idea what we're asking about.
Will that be all, then? Oh, dear, I don't think I can say this any more slowly. Unless... of course, it's Rockwell again. Who else? And I thought he was only holding me here to keep me out of the way. Chairman Rockwell. He's kept me under house arrest for years. I've long suspected him of transacting business in my name, but this proves it.
You've been all alone in this house? Would you like me to make you tea?
Please, this is important. Whatever it is that brought you here, Rockwell's the one behind it. How should I know? I've been under house arrest for years. But there is a way to find out, and perhaps to set things right. Whatever Rockwell's doing, he'll be doing it from the HHC headquarters. Your best lead is to look for details in his office.
This all feels off, Captain. Like when there's a storm coming, but everything's quiet and still.
Believe me, things have been off around here for a very, very long time. A reckoning is most certainly due.
This colony's problems have always seemed to trickle down from the top. If we're set on fixing Halcyon, that's as good a place as any to start.
Exactly. And fix it we must. Why, this is starting to sound like an issue of Dissident Hunter. Via the Acropolis District, of course. That's where the most important corporate and government facilities are. But only board employees are allowed into the district. There's a heavily guarded checkpoint just down the street. There might be a route through the maintenance tunnels, but I'm afraid I don't know specifics. Most people avoid the area for obvious reasons. When you reach the HHC building, this access card should get you up to the executive suites, where the chairman's office and what used to be my office are. Wait! Rockwell has one of the only terminals capable of transmitting to the Earthbound message drone. This is our chance. Please, take this and transmit it from his office. Rockwell hasn't given me any messages from Earth for years. He's desperate to keep me out of contact with the Earth Directorate. But they need to know what's happening here. What isn't on it is the real question. I've gathered meeting minutes, internal messages, sustainability reports, and more, all exposing the corruption and mismanagement plaguing Halcyon. Once the rest of the Earth Directorate sees it, they'll have to send help.
But they wouldn't get here for... I don't even know. Shouldn't we do something our own selves?
It's worth a try, but the Earth Directorate still needs that message. We must hope for their intervention. Perhaps there is hope after all. And now I entrust it to you. Good luck, and trust no one in the Acropolis District. What a pleasure. I haven't had this much. Haven't you heard? Chairman Rockwell and I are on a goodwill tour of the colony. Aside from battalions of UDL security forces, most of help. Besides, remaining close has allowed me to learn just how wrong things have gone around here. Except for the bit about my suddenly coming down with stomach flu last year. That truly happened. Probably because I've no interest in being his puppet. My predecessor was content to serve as Rockwell's lapdog. When he saw I meant to oppose him, he made sure I'd have little up. It's quite all right. I've got every back issue of Dissident Hunter to keep me company.
Oh, there. That's one right there.
The Acropolis District is off limits. Move along. What in the law's name are you on about? Sure. Let me just take that off your hands. Did I say restricted area? Slip of the tongue. What I meant was, welcome to the Acropolis District.
I'm not sure I have ever, in my entire life, felt more out of place than I do at this moment.
Welcome to the official headquarters of the Halcyon Holdings Corporation Board. Today's greeting is brought to you by Anticleo, a subsidiary of Colway Pharmaceuticals.
State your business. Please step away. This entry is for high priority HHC business only. Huh. I didn't realize we were still using those iridescent stickers. But this looks right. I'll just need you to register your weapons with a revised request to carry 32B form. Each weapon will need a separate form. I'm not authorized to employ humor on the job, sir. Now, let's see. Damn it. When did I run out of forms? You don't have to be sarcastic about it. Look, you don't have time to wait on new forms, and I can't afford the citations for impeding HAC business. So I'm going to save us both some trouble and waive your forms. Just know there are a bunch of guards upstairs, and they're all high on dervish mist and low on patience. So try anything funny, and they'll paint the walls with your guts.
Apologies for the wait. I was arranging my stationery. Personal assistant to Adjutant Akande and Chairman Rockwell. I'm also responsible for organizing the adjutant's stationery, which is more of a hobby. Ah. Oh, you were being serious. I'm obliged to inform you that Chairman Rockwell is unavailable for an indeterminate duration. Will there be anything else?
Excuse me, just a moment. Is there something I can do for you? I beg your pardon, Minister Clark's former office is currently closed to solicitors. What? Oh dear. Thank you for reminding me. I can't stand the thought of someone else's hands touching my custom letterheads.
One person gets all this space. Just to sign papers all day?
Good afternoon. I'm Chairman Rockwell, and I'm here to address a serious issue facing us. As you all know, our colony has been successful beyond our wildest dreams. Unfortunately, we've recently discovered that our food supply will not be able to sustain Halcyon's population in the long term. Everyone will die. Everyone will slowly stop living from malnutrition. But we're doing it together, and that's what matters.
I fucking swear, if someone doesn't give me something to read that will placate the masses soon, all of you will find yourselves violently unemployed.
But I can assure you there's nothing to fear. We've got a solution. It's called the Lifetime Employment Program. We will freeze most of the colony to preserve resources, while the best and brightest of Byzantium continue living in prosperity.
Look, you idiots! How many times do I have to tell you we can't say shit like that? Fire whoever wrote this!
While Halcyon's brightest minds solve the problem of our nutritional shortage, the rest of the colony will be placed in suspended animation. Individuals will be revived on a rotating basis so that every Halcyonite can be part of the important work of saving our colony. By testing paperweights. Sorry, couldn't resist. Let's go again. And someday, in the not-too-distant future when we've solved this crisis, we'll all be back together again working for the good of Halcyon. Until then, the board shall provide for the deserving just as it always has. So, obey your supervisors, take your vitamins, follow your corporate-mandated grooming rituals, and rest assured with the board on your side, there is nothing to worry about.
That was our story. It's not real.
Guess the whole colony's up a creek. I thought it was just Monarch.
Thank you.
I have to go through.
Not so fast. The Ministry of Accuracy and Morale is off-limits to everyone without X-36 level clearance. Basically, if you don't work here, or for Chairman Rockwell himself, you're not getting in. I don't know how you got that, but I still don't know you, and I don't have any new clearances on the list.
Got it? Inside voices.
What was that?
Talks. Do all ships do that?
I can't say for certain, since I only ever been on this one. Ada's something special, though, ain't she?
Ada, what is it? She? It? I'm a bit fuzzy on the details.
You have a message from Adjutant Sophia Akande.
No one ever looks quite the same in person as they do in my reports. And my reports of you have been exceptionally thorough. You've had quite a career. You have something I want. I'd like to negotiate. Phineas Wells is wanted by the board. I want to convince you to turn him in to us. He has a litany of charges against him. Vandalism, illegal experimentation, sedition. I could go on. Wells is a dangerous madman. His plan is going to endanger everyone in Halcyon. He's an obsessive psychopath. And he's using you. You're in contact with Wells. I want you to send us a tracing signal from his communication terminal. You're making a serious mistake.
Adjutant Akande's call has been terminated. Will there be anything else, Captain? We have successfully arrived at Phineas's orbital lab, Captain, and we are still in one piece. Shall I congratulate myself, or would you like to do the honors?
In your absence, optimized my formula. I'm now confident I can revive the remaining colonists. All I need now is the dimethyl sulfoxide. I'll take as much as you can give me. What? Oh, yes, well, that's obvious. Anyone with two working lamps can see this colony slouching toward oblivion. Why do you think we've been doing all this? I revived you to help me save Halcyon from annihilation. Hold on. Let me see if I understand this correctly. You're saying that Halcyon's on the brink of total collapse, and the chairman's plan to save all of us is to save himself? I always knew Halcyon was heading toward a systems collapse, but I never imagined we were already there. The board made this crisis, and now they want to solve it by freezing the rest of us? That's not a plan. That's a goddamn escape clause. That makes two things we don't have. Time and chemicals to revive the other settlers. None of this was supposed to happen. I was supposed to revive the Hope's colonists. We were supposed to have enough time to solve the problem before we all starved. Human test subjects. Oh, that's grotesque. That's unthinkable. That's exactly what I'd expect out of the board. Thank you. You've brought me enough chemicals to get started, at least. I'm just sorry they came at the cost of human lives. Those poor people, they must have died in agony. What exactly was the board trying to accomplish? You say the board's trying to freeze their subjects over and over again without inflicting permanent damage? Well, they're nowhere close to solving that problem. I'll tell you this much. The board scientists are hopelessly lost. After years of fruitless experimentation, they've made exactly zero progress. I used to work for these people. I'm intimately familiar with the utter incompetence of the board's own scientists. We're out of time. We're out of chemicals. We may very well be out of options. If the board has their way, we're all going to be spending the rest of our lives frozen in stasis. Do you realize what this means for the Hope? For your fellow colonists? The board's going to kill them all. Toss them out into space, just to make room in their hibernation chambers. Short of lining up every member of the board and shooting them in the back of the head. Do you know what's waiting for us on the Hope? Scientists, engineers, artists, the brightest minds Earth ever sent us, uncorrupted by the board. The board's going to dispose of them all and transform the Hope into a prison for the rest of us. They're likely on their way to the Hope as we speak. We need to get to those colonists before the board. I have enough chemicals to start reviving a few of them, but no easy way to get them off the Hope. Merciful gibbering law! You're a genius! We bring the Hope to us. Skip the entire ship across the distance of colony space, right next to my lab. Yes, exactly. You're a step ahead of me, but I perceive the shape of your plan. If we link up the Hope to the Unreliable, then use your navigational computer to calculate a reasonably safe vector, we can skip the entire colony ship into the rings of Terra 2.
I don't know much about skip drives, not the physics anyhow. I do know the Hope's real massive. How's our bitty little ship supposed to skip it?
Excellent question, my sharp-witted mechanic. You will use your own ship to power up the Hope skip drive. Your navigational computer can handle the rest. You'll need to switch on the Hope's auxiliary power using the Unreliable. Then head to the bridge. Your navigational computer, Ada, should be able to activate the Hope skip drive. Once you've skipped the Hope next to my lab, I'll have easy access to the frozen colonists. I can start reviving them immediately. I know you're wondering why I'm doing all this. Why I believe the people on the Hope are the answer to the colony's problems. The Hope is carrying some of humanity's most brilliant thinkers, scientists, engineers, experts in their field. If we work together, we can still find a way to save Halcyon. The board would have us believe Halcyon is beyond saving. I choose to believe otherwise. If there's even the slightest chance we can save Halcyon from oblivion, then we have to take it. Oh, it's not you. I do experiments in that room. Some of them get quite scientific. The unexpected is to be treasured, but from a safe distance. Regardless, it's quite comfortable in here, you know. I have my beans, have my caffeinoids, plenty of toilet paper.
We'll be right back.
I understand we have decided to continue supporting the outlaw scientist, Dr. We have arrived at the Hope. I need you to reroute power from our ship to the Hope's auxiliary generator. You'll have to connect me to the Hope's comm system so I can convince her central computer to enable the skip drive. If your calculations are even slightly off, you could crash the entire colony ship into Terra 2. Or the Sun. If you don't mind my saying, Captain, Minister Clark is lucky to have you on his side. Captain, I hope Dr. Wells has not dragged you into one of his irrational schemes again. My diagnosis of his mental stability is not flattering.
You know, when they posted us here, I told them there wasn't any point. Nobody would be so stupid as to fly to the ass end of the colony for this derelict. Shows how much I know. You've got about 5 seconds to tell me what you're doing here before I make you take a walk outside. Bullshit. If UDL was sending more folks, they'd have told us. I get you. This is the dullest job I've ever had. But orders set to stand here, so here I am. All right. You'll want a uniform so my staff doesn't shoot you on sight. They're a dangerous mix of bored and trigger happy. We've got a few extra in the old badge station to my right. Good luck.
going silent.
Good luck.
Poor bastard. You all right, Captain? I mean, seeing this place again?
Error. Hope crew data not found. Identify yourself. Error. This unit is not experiencing errors. Error. This unit is functioning correctly. There is no need for the intervention of mechanical engineers. Thank you for your cooperation.
Thank you.
That's the Hope's computer up ahead. I'll admit, I am curious to wake him. Greetings, Captain. I am speaking to you through the Hope's computer system. It's a rather cramped feeling, but it'll do. Are you sure? That is extremely dangerous. Skipping the Hope will void the warranty on the skip drive. And also potentially kill an entire planet. How is my humor now, Captain? Improved? Jump-starting the skip drive. Destination set to the rings of Terra 2.
Oh no. Captain, don't do this. I ain't dying on a fucking ship. I'm gonna die in the dirt like we're meant to.
Doing it. I mean, affirmative. Skipping the Hope in 3, 2, 1.
ADA, does your captain seriously intend to do a micro jump in system with engines that haven't been powered in 70 years on a derelict ship?
That is what my captain intends, yes.
But that is a gross misuse of the skip drive. The Zero-Point Drives Corp and I will not be held responsible for any damage incurred during transport, and this will cause extreme damage.
Yes, I am aware of that.
You should not be doing this. The humans will die.
Thank you, Hope. It looks like all systems are a go. Captain, I would advise you to hold on to something. Now. Oh, good. We are still alive and have successfully skipped into Terra 2's orbit. I reported as much to Phineas Wells, but he has not responded. Perhaps you should check in on him.
Oh. I feel like I've been turned inside out. Let's not do that again.
Hold it right there!
Hey, you! I don't recognize you. Are you new here? Oh, hell, no one informed me of any surprise inspection. Oh, of course. I'll just get out of your way.
Keep your hands to yourself.
I find myself glad.
That's the last of them.
Remember, not to get brakes on company time.
Huh? Hold it right there!
Here, they've found me somehow. They're about to blast my door open. I can't stop them from getting me, and there isn't enough time to explain everything. But there's something very important you'll need to remember. The board, all their lackeys, they're all a bunch of swine. Do you hear me? They're fucking corporate swine. You fucking pigs! I'll take you all out with me! I'll never...
It would seem the recording captured some rather dire events. I presume you'll want to dock at the Orbital Lab to check on your associate as soon as possible? How can I be of assistance? Take care. We have successfully arrived at Phineas's Orbital Lab, Captain. And we are still in one piece. Shall I congratulate myself, or would you like to do the honors?